Yo, what's going on, guys? Yumiko here, and today we're back with some more Clannad. Now, I believe that last time we left off, I think that was when we met that girl in the club room that was like, not the club room, but the old library. And for some reason, she was like serving us coffee. I don't know. It was kind of strange. But yeah, we're going to go ahead and jump right on back into it, and we're going to see what is in store for us. Because again, I am kind of interested in the scene where. Not only our relationship with, I always forget her name, but whatever. I return to the classroom, but Tsunahara is still MIA. He can go have fun on his own. Even after classes are over, Tsunahara doesn't show. I head to the drama club room by myself. As I do, Futakawa catches up to me. Before I realize it, the two of us are walking down the hallway side by side. Oh god, just to let you know, my voice is kind of fucked up, but we'll go for it. Hehehe. Futakawa matches my pace. I can see it's hard for her, but she's having fun doing it.
It's time for practice, right?
We're not practicing a play, you know. We're practicing your introduction speech.
I know that. Even so, I just feel excited about getting together and doing something productive for this. Don't you?
I can't really say I know what you're talking about. Hey, don't you think it'd be a good idea if you decided on what you're going to say ahead of time?
You're right. I'm good at memorization, so I should stick to that.
I'm not going to help you decide what to say or how to say it, though. I don't know a thing about drama. If anything, I'd want you to teach me about it.
I'm the same way, too. I just want to be in plays. I actually don't know a single in-depth thing about them.
A bombshell has just been dropped on the by the president of the drama club. Hey, Futakawa.
Yes?
Why do you want to be in plays?
Because I like them.
What about them do you like?
I think it's fun to be able to act with everyone. As a child, I was always absent during school arts festivals and things like that. That's why I was so dead set on joining the drama club. So when I started high school, I really wanted to work on my acting so that I could get cast in some of the plays. But I was in no state to do that during my first and second year. And I took all of my third year off.
Yeah, I guess that makes sense. In other words, her enthusiasm for being in plays is basically just a desire to work with others in a group. She wants to be a part of something where everyone comes together to accomplish a single common goal. And by doing that, she'd then be able to realize a dream that's gone unfulfilled all this time. That's all.
I just like them.
Futakawa lets out a small sigh, then presses her hands to her chest. She must have spoken for too long. She seems tired. She's this frail, this fragile. Yet she's trying to charge forward. How could you ignore her after seeing that? I certainly wouldn't be able to. You pass. So I tell her that.
Sorry?
Just use that as your speech, what you just said. It was kind of short, but I get this feeling that you were able to say exactly what you wanted to there.
Are you trying to console me?
No, I'm serious. I'm not the kind of guy to beat around the bush.
That's true. Sometimes you're so blunt it hurts a little.
Yeah, so you can believe me when I say that. The only problem is...
Sorry?
Whether you'll be able to say the same thing when it's time for the actual meeting.
Oh, you're right.
You tend to fold under pressure, right?
Yes, I do, unfortunately.
The question that pops into my mind next loops all the way back around at the beginning of our conversation. Then how are you going to be able to act in plays? Futakawa continues to practice for the information session.
The idea of everyone working hard toward the same goal. Is wonderful to me. Won't you work to accomplish those goals alongside me?
We decide to end it on that note. Her words are clumsy, but I have a good feeling about her tone. It's eager, genuine. Question. I raise my hand, pretending to be a new student.
Please go ahead.
What kind of plays are we gonna do? What's that drawing on the flyers? What kind of guys are you into? We gotta make sure that when curveballs are thrown, she's ready, right? Come on. Just in case. we can't come back to that spot. I don't think these choices matter too much, but what kind of guys are you into? They might poke fun at her too. How would she react to them? What kind of guys are you into?
Huh?
What's your type?
What? My type?
Yeah.
Let me see.
He's actually giving it some thought.
Someone who'll walk together with me. Or hold hands with me. Accept me for who I am. Oh, I feel like I'm being too picky. Forget what I just said.
That really isn't too much to ask for, you know. In fact, if she said things that were basic traits anyone could have, it'd just egg on whoever asked the question. If that's all you need, I can do that. Let's go out. And it'd probably turn into a situation like this.
Huh? You, Okasaki-san?
Of course not. I'm playing the part of some new student you've never met, remember?
Oh, of course.
She starts to blush and covers her face. They're so gonna poke fun at you. We continue practicing for another hour or so. Furukawa's voice starts to get hoarse, so we decide to stop for the day. Once again, the two of us start walking home together. I see a familiar guy ahead of us on the street. It's Tsunahara. What's he doing here at this hour? Furukawa is to my side. These two are the last people in the world I'd want to have to introduce to each other. Get far away from Furukawa and keep walking, grab Furukawa's hand and run past them. Let's grab her hand and run past them.
You know, that hedge.
Furukawa, let's go. I grab Furukawa's hand and tug.
Ah!
She seemed to be focused on something else, so she stumbles. Barreling to the ground, she lands on her hands and knees. In other words, I guess you should say, she just flat out fell. The worst. No, we're going back! We're not! Nope, we're not doing that. We'll go with the same options, but no way am I gonna let her fall on the ground. We're gonna get far away and keep walking. Hey, do you think we could walk farther apart for a bit?
Pardon?
Sorry, but I want you to pretend that we're strangers. I see someone I know.
Who is it? A friend? If it's someone you know, then I'd like to say hello, Okasaki-san.
Nah, you don't have to worry about it. I politely decline and push her away. I feel so bad. Furukawa gives me some space, a question mark still visible over her head. Just as she leaves, Tsunahara notices me and takes her place. Yo! Hey, you rat. I was nearly dragged off in your place because you were nowhere to be found.
Huh? I don't know what you could be talking about.
You keep this up and you're seriously gonna get yourself expelled.
Whatever, that's cool with me.
I glance behind Tsunahara. Furukawa is there, waiting faithfully. I motion to her with my head to go on ahead of us, but she doesn't seem to understand. She just tilts her head to the side.
Hey, aren't you hungry?
Yeah.
You want to treat me to something?
I don't have that kind of money.
How are you not going to repay the favor after all I've done for you? I let you use my room all the time.
What do you want me to treat you to? I look around. Nothing. There isn't anything here.
Oh, that vending machine over there is fine. Give me that caramel soda. It looks like it'll keep me full for a while.
It's his idea of a joke. There's no way Tsunahara would want something that sweet. But Furukawa, who's been pretending not to know us until now, overhears him and walks over to the vending machine. And then...
beep.
Thunk.
Huh?
Tsunahara turns around, reacting to the sound of the vending machine being used. There he sees Furukawa holding a can of soda like it's something highly important.
If you like, please take this.
She holds it out. As she does so, I cover my forehead with my palms.
What?
It's my treat.
Who the heck are you?
My name is Nagisa Furukawa. Okazaki-san has been helping me out a lot.
Is that so?
Tsunahara looks over to me. Yeah, it is. I reply grudgingly, my hands having slid down a bit to cover my eyes.
She's not your little sister, right?
Nope, she isn't.
How do you know each other?
Good question.
I wanted to make a drama club, and he's assisting me. But Okazaki-san isn't a member of the club. I'm the only one in it. I'm the club president.
Gah. She's telling him everything. Seriously?
Yep, that's right.
I have no choice but to come clean.
No wonder I couldn't find you after classes yesterday.
He makes an unpleasant giggle.
And the drama club at that. I'm surprised, Okazaki. You're interested in something as disgusting as club activities? I thought you hated kids in those clubs so much that they made you want to puke.
What?
Furukawa looks my way.
I suddenly feel the impulse to punch Sidara right in his stupid mouth.
That's how much I wish you wouldn't talk about this.
I thought that was the first thing we realized we had in common.
Just eat whatever you want. I pull a 1,000 yen bill from my wallet and shove it into Sunohara's chest.
Oh, thanks. It sure pays to ask. Later.
He leaves satisfied.
Okazaki-san, what your friend said?
I knew she'd be the kind of person who'd let that affect her. I was on the basketball team in middle school. I was on the varsity squad, but I got in a big fight with my father right before my last game. And I ended up injured, so I couldn't play. I quit after that. Why am I telling her my life story like this? I mean, just how badly do I want to tell Furukawa my sob story of a life? What, do I want her validation or something?
In that case, I want to help you.
I'm not surprised to hear those words.
I want you to be able to have hope while you're in high school. Just like I do.
She hides her face. She must be blushing. She probably wants to add, thanks to you. I only now realize how masochistic my confession was. I never wanted her to touch that scar. I can feel my face getting red. I see. It'd be nice if that could happen. So I look up at the sky. It shines silver beyond the roofs of the town's buildings. I wait for the wind to blow on my face and cool me down. 3 years ago. Life at school was going great for me. I was captain of the basketball team. Because of my athletics, I pretty much had any and every high school open to me to choose from. So the plan was to pick a good one and keep playing basketball once I got there. But that path was suddenly cut off. It was because of the fight I had with my father. It started over my appearance, or maybe it was how my shoes were messed by the front door. Either way, it was something stupid like that. Regardless, we started shoving each other, which eventually escalated things into a fight. Then I hit my right shoulder against the wall. No matter how intense the pain got, I stayed stubborn. I just shut myself in the room, refusing to do anything about it. By the time I did go to a doctor, it was already too late. I'd never be able to raise my right arm above my shoulder again. Damn. That's gotta suck. Just completely, like, ruining what you had going for you. The sky is overcast. My mood drops like an anvil out of a third floor window. Maybe it's the weather's fault. I hear the sound of approaching footsteps.
Okazaki-san! Good morning!
Furukawa naturally walks up by my side. Yeah, morning. Those are the only words I say to her before falling silent.
I have a proposal, Okazaki-san.
When we get to the bottom of the hill, Furukawa starts to talk. What is it?
We should play basketball after school today.
Oops. What? Who's this we?
You and I, Okazaki-san.
Huh?
I'll be waiting for you by the school athletic grounds after school. I'll be there waiting with basketball in hand.
What a stupid idea. What are you, stupid?
I may not seem like it, but I'm actually quite athletic.
That's not what I mean.
I can even shoot the ball as long as I throw it underhanded. And if I'm standing still, I can dribble too.
That would make you unathletic.
What? Really?
Yeah. So don't bother. You're not cut out for it. Just focus on the drama club.
But I want you to know too.
Know what?
That you can put your all into something.
A concept that's further removed from my life than just about anything else I can think of. The idea of working hard towards something seems unimaginable to me after what I've gone through. Which one of us here ended up with a whole lot of nothing to show for all their efforts? The thought makes me sick. If you want to play, go play on your own.
No, I'd rather play together.
I'm going straight home today, alright? After telling her that, I head to my class. I don't see Sunohara. He'll probably show up late like he always does. Sunohara appears with bloodshot eyes once first period ends.
Hey, morning! Don't Saturday get you excited?
Yeah, they do.
I mean, school ends after just 3 hours.
4 hours for most of us.
Let's go do something after class is over. Have a little fun. What about hitting on girls from another school for a change?
It's gonna rain this afternoon, you know.
What? Seriously?
Did you walk here with your eyes closed? Look at how ridiculously cloudy it is outside.
But my hot weekend Saturday night fever.
You're being awfully redundant. In the middle of class. What's that? I look outside the windows, everything the teacher says goes in one ear and out the other. As classes have started, there's nobody around the school gate. There's something near the gate I don't recognize. What is it? Since it's moving, it's likely an animal, but I can't say for sure what it is. It's too big to be a cat. Yet too round to be a dog. A raccoon? Well, its tail's too short for that. The pattern on its body is rather unique. It looks kind of like vertical stripes. In any case, the animal-like thing is happily rubbing... Is that its face? Against the wall next to the gate. The way that it's taking small but quick steps is rather cute. The bell rings.
I think it's the, I don't know what it is, but it's like some pig-looking thing. It's, it shows up as the icon of the game when you, like, have it on your desktop, so...
Hey, Okazaki, where are you going?
There's something bugging me.
Something interesting?
Probably something boring.
I'm coming too, then.
Don't. You'll just get in the way.
Don't say that now. I'd be bored staying in the classroom by myself.
You don't have any friends, do you?
I don't want to hear that from you!
Should be around here. I wonder where it went. I really want to know what kind of animal that was.
Are you looking for something?
It's not really... Rub, rub.
Mm-hmm.
Something's rubbing against my legs.
Yeah, there it is.
Pee pee. Man, what the heck?
Rub, rub.
Hey, Okazaki, what's that? Pee pee.
No idea. What is this animal? It's neither a dog nor a raccoon, and it has vertical stripes on its back. By the looks of it, it's still a child.
Pwee. It's cute.
Yeah, it is a charm that cats and dogs don't have.
Is it okay if I touch it? Will it bite?
Well, since it came to us, I don't think it's hostile.
Let's touch it then! Let's pat it and hug it too!
Sunohara reaches his hands out to touch the small animal.
Pwee. Don't run away!
When his hand almost touches the small, cute animal.
Hey, you!
Sunohara, Tomoya, and blank. Eh? I turn around to face the familiar voice. As I do so, something flies by my eyes.
Whack!
Ah! When I look down at my feet, I find a Japanese-English dictionary tumbling across the ground. By the way, Sunohara, whose nose is bleeding, is also tumbling across the ground.
What do you mean, by the way?
Don't read my mind.
Ow, what a crazy thing to have come flying toward me. If it hit me in the wrong spot, I'd be dead by now. Besides, who was that?
What?
Whack!
As he tries to get up, he gets kicked to the ground again. Before I can say anything, he flips through the air and hits the ground again. I think we all know who this is.
It's, Tomoyo.
Watch out!
Too late!
He responds with a disapproving tone as his hands and feet twitch.
Pee pee.
Oh, it's Kyo.
Phew, sheesh. What are you trying to do to my pet?
The culprit from whom Sunohara received that magnificent kick says, as her long hair flutters in the wind. My pet?
Yep, that's my pet.
You mean this round thing?
Pee pee. Isn't it cute?
Is it some new breed of dog or raccoon?
Are your eyes stuffed with marbles? Just why would you think this is a dog or a raccoon?
What is it then?
It's a piglet.
Pig shit?
I'll kill you.
Don't say that with a smile. It's creepy.
Piglet. Do you get it if I say it's a boar?
Well, what is it? Is it a baby or something?
It's a baby boar.
Pee-pee.
What?
It's a pet?
Yeah, that's right.
Pee?
If you have something to say, say it.
Are you serious?
Very serious. Oh, you want to know what it's called? It's really cute, you know.
Let's hear it.
He's called Botan. Isn't it really cute?
Pee.
Sounds pretty delicious.
Mm-hmm. What's that?
Nope, never mind.
That hurts. My nose feels like it's on fire.
You awake?
Yeah. Anyway, you guys say something about a Botan stew? I'll have to go back to my dorm for the miso. Also, it seems I was kicked just now. I think I caught a glimpse of something light blue. Light blue honing in on me along with the bottom of a shoe.
I bet that was her pants. Erase that from your mind!
Thwack!
Gwah! Ha! Ha! You heard that?
Didn't hear a thing. I didn't have any other choice. So what's that piglet doing here?
You're here to see me, right?
We still have class, right? What are you gonna do?
Yeah, well...
Pee-pee!
Okay, Botan. I can't go home yet.
Pee.
Be good and go home now.
Pee.
I'll come home right away when school's over.
Pee.
It's okay. This guy here will walk you home.
Hey, why are you pointing at me?
He really likes taking walks, so who knows where he'd go if nobody was watching him. And so, you're watching him.
What?
You don't listen in class anyway. In that case, isn't it better if you make yourself useful?
You're kidding. I can sleep in class. You mean to tell me that there's something more important than that?
Okay, quit complaining. If you take him home, I'll treat you to lunch.
Leave it to me. I pound my chest in agreement. But I don't know where you live.
Oh, that's okay. Botan can take you there. You just need to follow him and keep an eye out for cars, crows, and a baker with a menacing look to him.
So what if something happens to him?
You know what's gonna happen. Your lifespan will just shorten quite a bit.
I really wish you would stop saying ominous things so casually. Is anything okay for lunch?
As long as it's from the cafeteria.
I'll take you up on that.
Just come back while I'm still on campus.
Okay, let's go, Piglet.
Pahee!
It speeds off quickly.
Whoa, he's surprisingly fast.
Okay now, he's leaving you behind.
Oh, I'll leave that little guy lying over there to you.
Give him another 5 minutes. He'll wake up.
I guess that's true.
Pahee pahee!
Hey, he's calling you.
Oh, damn. Wait up my lunch.
Don't say something so disturbing!
It's pretty close.
I yell and run after the small animal. So, after I'd run for several minutes, I completely lost sight of the baby boar. This is bad. Hell, it's not a matter of being treated to lunch anymore. For something so tiny, he sure is fast. Well, I'm sure I can get home by itself. I guess all I can do now is hope that's the case. Even if I look, I don't think I'd be able to find him. I guess I'll just try to kill some time and then go back to school. I returned to school after fourth period and homeroom was over. Only students who had club activities were still around. Let's try not to bump into Kyo.
Ah! Welcome back! Did you get Botan home?
Of course!
I see. Thanks. I'll teach you to lunch like I promised then. Oh, as I said before, it's limited to what we can get at the cafeteria.
Nah, it's fine.
Huh? How come?
Ty got hungry on my way, so I bought something to eat. I'm okay right now.
Right now, you say? I'm not treating you to anything if you pass this up, you know.
Well, I guess we can't help it.
That's Kind of suspicious.
Anyway, I'm fine.
Ah.
I turn around and dart down the hallway as if I'm running away from her. I go back to the classroom to get my bag. Sunohara is hanging out there alone, waiting for me.
Finally, Okazaki, you're back.
Ah, you've come back to life. Impressive.
Back to life? I didn't even get scratched. I dodged everyone.
When you say it that casually, I almost feel like believing you. What should I do? Say please.
Please!
Okay, you dodged everything. It was amazing.
Yeah, I guess so. So, what now? Ready to bounce out of here?
Like I just told you, it's gonna rain.
Hey, Sunohara!
It's our homeroom teacher's voice.
Today's the day. You're finally coming with me to the teacher's room.
He weaves his way through the desks towards us.
Oh, crap!
Just let me handle this. You jump out the window and run.
Alright! Wait, I'd die if I did that!
Okay, then I'll stall for time. So you go buy me some melon bread and juice.
Alright! Wait, you just want me to be your gopher?
Gotcha. Oh, that's him.
Gotcha!
Our teacher grabs Sunohara by the shoulder.
Gah, he got me while I was distracted playing along with this dumb skit of yours.
You two really are good friends, aren't you? In that case, why don't you come with...
I'm going home. I'm already in the hallway. As I leave, I hear Sunohara roar, "Are you deserting me?" Through the window, I look up at the clouds in the sky. I wonder if Futakawa is waiting on the ground somewhere, a basketball held to her chest. I don't see anything like that from here, so I just keep staring into the gray abyss above, hoping that it doesn't rain. It's the least I could pray for. I see Futakawa there. She's standing motionless, waiting as she holds a ball to her chest. I don't want to tell her the reason why I quit playing basketball, but she'll probably keep trying to get me to play until she hears it. Ugh, what a bad situation to be in. She'll probably go home once it gets dark, though. I hide inside the crowd of other students who don't participate in after-school activities before leaving school. The door opens with a click.
Phew! Whoa, someone's in my room!
Welcome back.
Hey, you shouldn't go into other people's rooms without their permission. You'll surprise them.
Next time I wait for you, I'll do my best corpse impression.
That's creepy, man!
Sunohara closes the door and takes off his jacket.
I really got chewed out this time.
And you're next, you know.
You basically live here, so they'll find you if they come by.
Are you serious? I wonder if university's even a possibility. You think they'll let you go to university? No way.
I'm talking about you, too!
I guess it really is raining now. Sunohara looks up at the sky through his window.
Now we can't go anywhere.
Great, alone with another guy in my room all day. If you don't like it, then leave.
This is my room!
Well, it's better than being alone, isn't it?
I guess that's true.
Right? That's why the two of us should play a crazy game. We'll run totally naked through the rain. When you lose in rock, paper, scissors, you have to strip and run through the rain. You'll be infamous.
When I lose? What about when you lose?
Alright, here goes.
What?
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
Alright, I win.
Damn it.
Okay, once more. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Yeah, two in a row.
Hurry up and lose. I want you out there running.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Look at that. Three wins in a row. Hey, wait, does this game just keep going until I lose?
Pretty much.
That's not a game, that's bullying.
The two of us are sprawled out on Sunohara's floor, just reading magazines. I can tell by the sound of the rain that it's coming down harder now.
Any club that does stuff outside would have to be canceled today.
The rugby team might be heading back here.
I'm begging you, please don't cause any trouble.
There's no way she'd be waiting in this rain, right? Standing out in this heavy rain would be awful, after all. Go check on her or stay.
Knowing Futakawa, she would totally be standing out there in the rain.
We're going to go check on her, because I guarantee you she's out there. I'm heading out. I stand up.
Huh? You're going to run through the rain naked?
Yeah, that's exactly what I'm going to do. Minus the naked part. I borrow one of the dorm's umbrellas and take off running in the rain.
Furukawa. I told you. Furukawa was waiting there, still clutching the ball to her chest. She's drenched, without so much as an umbrella.
What are you doing, stupid?
I rush over to her.
Oh, Okazaki-san. I'm glad you came.
How long have you been waiting here? You're soaked.
And I borrowed this, too. I'll need to wipe it off before I return it.
She looks down at the ball she's holding.
The ball isn't going to catch a cold. You need to be worried about yourself. Here, I'll let you borrow this umbrella. Just hurry up and get back home.
I hold out the umbrella. Large raindrops start falling on my head.
No, let's play basketball.
How can we play on a court that's this wet?
Does that make it not possible?
That's right. Now be a good girl and go home.
Then could you please at least make a shot for me? I want to see you do it. I've never seen someone who was in the basketball club take a shot up close. You don't throw it underhanded like I do, right? I bet you look really cool when you do it. Which is why I want to see you do it. Please.
She pushes the ball into my chest. Am I really going to have to show her after all? I throw the umbrella to the ground and take the ball. How many years has it been since I've held one of these? I slowly turn around to face the basketball court, now covered in rain. Yeah. I just have to show her. Once I do, she'll be happy. I try to hold the ball above my shoulders, but as I go to it, it spills from my hands. It falls to the wet ground and splashes mud everywhere. I pick it up and try to lift it above my shoulders once more. But despite my efforts, my arms lower themselves again, powerless. I toss the ball to the ground. Furukawa is dumbfounded. She doesn't seem to understand what's going on at all. Hey, Furukawa.
Yes?
I can't do it.
Excuse me?
As you can see, I can't shoot a basketball. I can't lift my shoulders up. I got hurt once, and ever since then. What must she be thinking right now? She just gazes at the ball as it sits on the ground. She must be regretting her conceited kindness right now. You don't throw it underhanded like I do, right? I bet you look really cool when you do it. The remark she made to me, someone who can't move his shoulders, must be spinning around in her mind right now.
I'm sorry. I didn't know. I really am an idiot. I'm so very sorry.
Just before she turns around to leave, I notice that she's crying. I can see her trembling cheeks. Furukawa runs off holding the still muddy ball. I assume she'll head home now, but she'll probably be feeling depressed. I was too harsh when I confronted her with the truth. What should I say to her the next time we see each other?
Whoa, dude, you're seriously drenched!
Yeah, because I went running out there.
Phew.
Drip, drip, drip.
Don't come in here all wet like that!
Here, take a towel. Thanks.
Ew, this reeks!
No, it doesn't, liar. I washed it and everything.
Oh, I'll admit I let my biases get in the way there.
If you're gonna use a hairdryer, do it in the bathroom.
Okay. Once evening comes, I find myself in the rain once again, this time in search of dinner. I'm actually under an umbrella, unlike before. Bread? I doubt I'd be able to make dinner out of it. But I just wanted to know whether she's actually home or not. I can't tell from where I'm standing. I guess I'll buy dinner somewhere else. I go inside.
Oh, if it isn't Big Bang Yamamoto.
He seems to now call me by only a strange stage name. It's Okazaki.
Oh yeah, that's it. I forgot you had a grubby little name like that. So, what do you want? You here as a customer? You here to buy something today, right? You're gonna buy some of Senai's bread. All of the leftovers, in fact, right? Now pay up. I know you're loaded. Parents these days spoil their kids so much.
Come on, jump up and down for me.
He's like the schoolyard bully shaking down an elementary school student. I'm not a customer.
Did Furukawa come home?
Furukawa's my name, but you ought to call me Akio-sama.
No, I'm talking about your daughter.
Oh, Nagisa? What'd you want with her? You better not lay hands on her. Don't make me go ape on you.
Is she back yet or not?
I don't think I can reveal that information to you. You want to buy some bread? If you do, I'll tell you.
Oh, Grand Cross Okazaki-san.
Close. She got the Okazaki part right. It's just Okazaki.
Oh, I'm sorry, Okazaki-san.
Is Nagisa home?
No, she hasn't returned today yet.
Gah, Sanai, you can't spill the beans to him like that.
Why not?
Because...
Pops here was trying to make me buy your bread in exchange for that information. Seems like he can't sell any unless he does something shady like that.
Ugh.
Is that true, Aki-sama? Akio-san?
No, Sanai!
My bread! My bread!
She starts to sniffle.
Is it just a big burden on Furukawa bread, isn't it?
She darts off.
Sanai! Damn it.
Furukawa's dad starts stuffing leftover bread into his mouth, and then...
I love you!
He follows after, screaming all the way. I just stare at the scene like an idiot. I have something else I need to be doing. Furukawa isn't back yet. This is a serious situation. I go back outside.
Ah!
I hear a voice from behind me.
Please wait, universe pronounced Okazaki-san.
My name is both written and pronounced Okazaki, you realize.
Is she not at school either?
I saw her leave from here, but I don't know where she went after that.
Is this unlike her?
I have a feeling it is.
Then I'll go look for her too.
What about the store?
It's okay. Akio-san will be there.
I have a feeling the store would be better off unattended if he's your alternative. Then I'll search the road at school, and,
My name's Sanai.
Right. Then, Sanai-san, you can check where you think she might go.
Okay.
Sanai-san puts up her own umbrella and rushes into the rain. After I see her run off, I start retracing the path I took to get here. I see a small umbrella flapping about the edge of the road. I head toward the same side of the road and realize that it is a child, about elementary school age. Could he be looking for something? I pass by and head to school. The place is deserted. I've searched all around the club rooms in the courtyard, but Furukawa is nowhere to be found. I trudge along. I'm out of the places to search. All I can do now is hope that Sanai-san comes up with something. I see the small umbrella again, still in the same place. I stop and stare for a while. Suddenly, I hear the whimper of an animal close to my ears. Caught by surprise, I look beside me to find a puppy on top of the wall. It's soaked and shaking. It probably can't get down. I reach out and hold it up. It has a collar on. I see, I think. As the child approaches me, I hold out the puppy. Is this what you were looking for? The child glances up and quickly breaks into a smile.
Oh, that's great. Where was he?
Over there. I apathetically point toward the wall, then start to leave.
Oh, wait!
He calls out for me to stop. To thank me? I don't even care about that. It's a pain. I decide to ignore the words.
Do you know where that big sis is?
But his words make me turn around. Who are you talking about?
Big sis. She's helping me find him.
Are you talking about your own sister?
No, I don't know who she is, but she said she'd help me look.
Was she wearing a school uniform?
I think.
Which way did she go?
I don't know. But she said she'd come back here when she found him.
I see.
What should I do?
He sounds worried as he passed the puppy's head. You ought to go home.
Huh?
It's late. Your parents are probably worried. You'll catch a cold if you stay in the rain any longer. The same goes for that dog.
But...
I'll thank her for you, so get going.
Really?
Yep.
Thanks. Promise me you will, okay?
Yeah. Leave it to me.
See ya!
Yeah. Be careful not to slip. I can hear the splish splash of the child's footsteps as he runs off. What an innocent kid. Alright then. When's she gonna give up and come back? My only option is to wait. How long has it been by now? Just as my wet hands start to feel numb and achy, I see the silhouette of someone hurrying towards me, no umbrella in hand.
I finally found him. He's alright. It's cold.
Futakawa comes back holding an animal to her chest.
Is this who you were looking for?
Looking at what she's holding. That's not it.
What? Oh, Okazaki-san.
She seems to have finally realized that it's me, not the kid who's waiting for her.
Was there a small child here?
There was. I made him go ahead and head home because it was getting late.
Said I need to give him this. He's worried.
He found his dog. He went home resisting easy. He went home resting easy.
What? Then whose is this?
He took the words out of my mouth.
But he was shivering under a guardrail.
Well, it's definitely not a dog.
Is that so?
She stoops forward, her hands on her knees. She grasps the wild piglet in her arms even harder.
I'm such a dummy.
She lets out a cough. Are you okay?
Yes, I'm fine.
She kneels next. You really are an idiot. Let's go. I pull her up by her shoulders. Hey, anyone home? Futakawa's home is abandoned. What is that dad of hers doing? He even abandoned his store duty. I decide to enter so that I can get Futakawa to a place where she can sleep. Actually, if she went straight to sleep, she'd definitely catch a cold. Her entire body's drenched. Her clothes must be wet down to her underwear. But it's not like I could change her clothes for her.
We're back!
That's when I hear Sanae-san's voice. I'm saved.
Okazaki-san!
I found her. She's soaked, so please have her change clothes.
Okay, I understand.
I leave the rest in her hands and start to leave. It'd be improper for me to stay any longer. I step down from the hallway to the entryway.
Welcome!
Oh, it's just you. Futakawa's dad is there.
And wait, you're coming down from the hallway. Of course you're not a customer. God, I'm a moron. Make yourself scarce. I don't feel like keeping this door open any longer today.
Beads of water are still dripping from my bangs as he yells at me. The cigarette in his mouth has been put out too.
Gah, look at how many stupid leftovers we have again. You want to take these home, kid?
I don't want him, old man. I make sure to stress the old man to get back at him for calling me a kid.
Huh, you really are a nice soldier, you know that? Okay, get lost.
Yep. I take the umbrella up to the entrance and step outside under the overhang.
Hey, kid.
He's probably gonna make another weird parting threat. I ignore him. I feel like the last thing I hear through the sound of the rain are a few words of gratitude. And then...
Pee-hee.
Am I gonna have to return this thing to its owner? I grab it and pick it up. The Illusionary World 3. Alright. I'm standing on a piece of earth as the wind howls behind me. It feels as though it's blowing from the edge of the world, with nothing standing in its way. Even this body of mine can feel its strength. Countless lights dance on the earth as if stirred by the wind. A girl is standing among them. They're stirred again, and many of the lights leap up from the ground. The girl looks up at them. This is the world I was born into. I think about how illusionary it is. Trees, grass, stones that roll by me, they all seem completely natural. They're supposed to be here. But what are the lights? I'm sure I hadn't known about this spectacle for a long time. The wind picks up again and one of the lights passes by me. I try chasing after it. It's floating there, right within arm's length. I reach out to it. The light slips through my fingers of junk.
It's not like they'd be able to change anything even if they could grab hold of it. I stand there dumbfounded. The sight of the girl's shadow tells me that she's by my side, though. I point at one of the lights. "What is it?" the girl asks. I'm unable to answer. "Does that light seem strange?" I nod. "What about the sky?" I shake my head, no. "The ground?" No. "Just this light?" Nod. "Why could that be?" The girl puts a hand to her chin as she thinks. I try to do the same, but the joint on my elbow doesn't bend that far. So I wait there, my arm bent unnaturally. She's always lived here. The light must be no different to her than my impression of the water and the trees. They're a part of nature. But they're the one thing I can't touch, which makes me think that they must be shadows. But shadows are all cast by something, right? So where could that thing be? I look, but it's nowhere to be found. "So that means," the girl begins, "if we're able to think of something as strange, we know what normal looks like." "Perhaps." I nod. I search the depths of my memories. One day, long ago, or maybe in the distant future, I'm not sure, I was in a different world. I remember the feeling of being there, but nothing else. Thinking about it warms the very bottom of my heart. What kind of place was it? I shake my head. Was it better than here? Probably. Did you like it there? I think. Was it less lonely than this place? The girl has always been alone. I found out that this place really does have nothing. That it's a lonely place, devoid of fun. And that's why I was born here. That's right. This is a lonely world, isn't it? Hey, did you want to be born in this world? I'm unable to tell her my answer. I simply take her hand. That is my answer, I suppose. All right. Oh, okay. We're ending off on a pretty good point there. Okay, we're gonna go back to the menu, return to title screen. Alrighty, well, that was... Damn. So obviously, you know, the whole, I guess, point of that, you could say, was the fact that Furukawa was, you know, obviously attempting to show kindness, because that's kind of her nature, right? But then it's this whole thing of, like, you know, hey, you gotta kind of learn when to lay off, I guess. Because she obviously meant it in, like, good faith and was intending to kind of repay Okazaki for helping her. But it kind of had the adverse effect. So, but it is kind of a showing of her character with how she, you know, waited in the rain until he came. And even when he did come, he, you know, she was like, "Hey, I'm not going. You're gonna take the ball and shoot it, and then I'll go." So it definitely shows her character there and how very I guess kind and considerate she is naturally. Which, of course, that can kind of come off in a negative light in some situations and contexts. But yeah, I mean, like, she's obviously going to get sick from this. My only thing is that she mentioned that for a long time she was out of school for, like, you know, 2 years and some change because of her frail state. And we even mentioned her frail state earlier. So I am kind of, like, curious how standing out in the rain like that without an umbrella and in wet clothes for all that time could potentially affect her. But, yeah. That's going to be it for this time. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, make sure to leave a like on the video and tell me in the comments section below what you'd like to see me play next. If you enjoyed this video or any other videos or series on my channel, then I highly recommend that you hit the subscribe button and turn on post notifications so you'll be notified when a new one of those videos comes out. Anyways, that's it from me, and I'll see you in the next one.